In today's beginner-friendly art tutorial, illustration and watercolor painting come together as we work through these beautiful anemone flowers. Hi friends, welcome back. My name is Shada, and today we are doing one of my favorite things, and that is an illustrated watercolor painting. Finishing your watercolor piece in pen gives you so much precision and control, and so that it's a great beginner project. This is what my painting looks like when it's all done. And before we jump into it, I want to mention I have something special this week for my patrons. What I've done is photographed my painting, and then I did a digital drawing over top of it. So let me get rid of the painting so you can really see. So this illustration will be available as a coloring page. You can print it out. Here it is on computer paper. You could also print it onto 90-pound watercolor paper or simply transfer it yourself onto watercolor paper using carbon or graphite paper. So that way you can paint along with me. If you want to, you can skip the illustration part and just focus on the color mixing and the brush work and just have fun with it. So head over to Patreon. After today's tutorial, all the bonus content is available there for just a couple bucks a month. All right, let's get started, and we'll start by talking about supplies. I am using computer paper or scrap paper, as well as tracing paper and graphite transfer paper, which I will grab in a second. And then you'll want to have a pencil and an eraser, as well as a fine liner like a Pigma Micron. Of course, we're using watercolor paper, and I have hot pressed 140-pound paper. Hot pressed is a wonderful smooth finish, which is nice for drawing on. Then I have my Mungyo watercolor set. This is a 48-pan, great color selection. I have two glasses of clean water, and then I have a number of round sable hair brushes. Sable hair is a type of weasel. It's a very good quality brush that holds its shape very well and will last a long time. Now I have a number 9, a 6, and a 4 here. And I like a pointed round brush because it has a large belly that holds lots of paint, but it also comes to a delicate point. Let me show you when I get them wet. You can really see that big belly and fine point means I can hold lots of paint, but I can also do detail works, thin lines, delicate bits. So a selection of these brushes is so important. And if you need more info about brushes, check out my watercolor e-course. It's on my website, shadacampbell.com. And use the Amazon links in the video description below to purchase these supplies for yourself. Okay, let's get our project started. The first thing I'm going to do is use my scrap paper to create a guide for my painting. And I'm doing that by putting circles and ovals everywhere I want my flowers to sit. So don't try drawing the flowers first, just figure out where they are going to be. I'm using a circle for open flowers, and I'm using an oval to represent angled flowers. And you can see that as I begin to draw in the petals, just very roughly. The circles are these big open flowers with equally sized petals. And I might put another layer of petals in behind the front ones. And then the ovals represent angled flowers, and by making an oval shape and then placing the stamen low in that oval, it creates a guide that helps me know exactly how large to make the front petal. You want quite a shallow front petal to make it look like the anemone is angled. If I get close here, you can see this one is just a big open flower, equally spaced. And then this guy over here, he has three large petals, and then the front petal is much shorter. And that gives us this nice foreshortening that helps with the depth and perspective. Now the next step is to go over our guide in pen, or our illustration in pen. You could skip this. I kind of like to do the pen bit because it helps me kind of finalize everything. The anemones are known for their beautiful, crazy stamen, and I draw that by doing a dark circle in the center, then doing a whole circle fanning out of these little lines, and then at the end of all those little lines, I place clusters of dots. So it's a lot of fun to illustrate, and I paint it pretty much the same way. And that's the nice thing about doing the illustrated watercolor project is that if you don't have a lot of skill with the paintbrush yet, you can just kind of paint these flowers as big blobs, very perfectly imperfect, and then add all the detail later in pen. So if you're more comfortable with pen, which I was for a very long time, still am probably more comfortable, this is a good kind of hack. So what I'm doing here is just adding some detail to my illustration, going over everything in pen, making sure I like the way things look, working out smaller details like the shape of each petal and the shape of each stamen. And then once I am happy with that illustration, one more leaf in there, I'll grab the tracing paper and we will trace it. And tracing, as I say, every time we trace, it allows you to refine your illustration. So you're going to be able to keep what you like about your drawing and change what you don't. So if one flower needs to be a little bigger or smaller, those are the type of changes you can make. There is my simple trace, and the trace also allows us to transfer the design onto the hot pressed watercolor paper. So we'll tape that in place. Then we'll grab our carbon or graphite transfer paper. I'm using carbon paper today. We'll stick that underneath and then take a nice sharp pencil and just go over your entire design. I tend to trace all the flowers and stems, but I won't go over the leaves because I like to paint them in, and I just feel having the leaf trace there, it makes my painting too stiff. So transfer as much as you like. And then we are going to mix up our paint. Now, my color palette today is somewhat pastel. We're kind of getting into spring colors, and most of the flowers are going to be peach. So I'm mixing a lot of white and a lot of water with a bit of a peachy tone that's in this palette. But then I'm also going to mix up some darker peaches. So I've mixed in a little orange, a little red, still lots of white in there and still lots of water. But I have a selection now of colors to pull from when I begin painting my flowers. And if color mixing is something that you're still struggling with or still have questions about, consider checking out the e-course because I do give a lot more info in that course when I have the time to do so. Okay, let's jump over here and we'll start laying down some paint. With an illustrated piece like this, the painting is a lot of fun. It's very easy, very approachable. You can see I'm not really doing much else here other than just slapping down some color. So even as the paint begins to dry, you can see it's kind of drying funny, and that's not going to matter. I actually like the way the paint settles into hot pressed paper. It kind of leaves some spots dark and some are lighter, and those happy accidents I think are so pretty. They can be problematic, but in this piece it is not going to matter at all because we're going to put those dark black pen lines on this later. So just paint those flowers in without too much thought. Then I'm going to mix up a little bit of green for the stems and branches. I'm mixing blue and green together. I'll likely put some purple in there later, and I have some dark green and then some lighter green. So just keep mixing water in. If your colors are too dark, you know, add a bit of white, add a bit of water. And here you can see I'm doing a little more brush work. So with the leaves, I'm pulling the belly of the brush across the page to create that shape of the leaf. And then I use the point of that round brush to do the stems and branches. So that's a great way to practice your brush work. And with the flowers, you don't need as much precision. You're just, you know, getting some color on the page. So this is a great project if you're just starting out. You can do this, especially because you can transfer my painting, my drawing, onto the page, and then you can just paint that. So transfer it using the graphite transfer paper and then add the color yourself. You can see I've mixed quite a bit of blue and gray into my greens. I'm also mixing gray and purple together with a lot of water and a bit of white. And that is going to be kind of my secondary color for the leaves. So right now I have some bluish leaves, some green leaves, and now I've got this very gray, milky purple tone, and I'm going to add a bit of that. And I think that looks really pretty with the dark green and the light peach, and then this gray purple. I really like this color palette, and it's a little bit in between winter and spring, which is kind of where we are right now. Well, let's be honest, it's still winter, but we're hoping for spring. And this is coming together. I have pretty much finished all my foliage around the flowers, and now I'm taking a dark brown and I'm going to start painting in these stamens. Now remember, you can draw this in. You can do this part in pen. So if you're like, I don't want to paint that, just skip it. I actually grabbed a smaller brush. This is a number one pointed round. I'll link that in the description as well. And you're going in first, painting that circle, dark circle, then this fan of little lines, just tiny little lines, very broken, very perfectly imperfect. And then come back in with more paint on the brush and begin doing those dots. And they should be pretty random. Some should be larger, some should be smaller. You don't want too much symmetry here. If things look too good, it'll look weird. It should look a little wonky and unsymmetrical. All right, with the leaves and flowers done and the stamens painted, my final step was simply to add a little bit of darker color to some of the light flowers, just to add that bit of shading, but you don't have to do that. And then we'll let our painting dry completely. Once it has, check that it is dry, really check. It probably takes about half an hour. And then you can grab a fine liner pen, something like a Pigma Micron, and we're going to start going around and just adding that nice black line. You should still be able to see some of your carbon transfer paper lines showing through the paint, especially if you're doing light peaches like I am. And so you can follow those lines, and you can also add more lines, add more detail. As you go around the petals, make sure to wiggle the pen just a little bit so that the lines aren't too smooth or too straight. They should look a little bit broken and a little bit shaky. I tend to like that because it helps with the natural look of the flower. And this just really brings this painting to life. One nice thing you can do with the pen is to really get in there and do a lot of line shading. And I think that really adds some oomph to the painting. Just adding those extra lines creates such a nice contrast. So don't be afraid to really add a lot of lines on the leaves or even on the flowers themselves. In the end, I decided to add quite a bit of line shading. And on the flowers, I did these little lines kind of where the petals met to show that it would be darker there, it would be in shadow. And then I also just did these curving, sort of broken lines along each petal. And they help show a bit of texture. They help to show the shape of the petals, and they really just help to make the whole painting pop. As I already said, the contrast between the light watercolor paint and all these black lines, I think it looks so pretty when you're all done. And so that's what you see me adding here, just those broken lines, and always follow the shape of the petal, and your line shading will look great. Okay, and that's it. The illustrated watercolor anemones are all done. I really love the way this turned out. And just a reminder, if you would like to print my illustration and paint that yourself, you can grab that on Patreon. All the bonus content is available for a couple bucks a month. And I'm also doing a live stream art class now for 10 bucks a month if you'd like to join in and ask your questions live. Thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button, and I will see you soon with a new tutorial.